Hello and welcome viewers and subscribers of AVG News. My name is Mkolisi, the son of Nube. I hope I find you well already, having a wonderful weekend. I just want to update you, as I had promised, about what transpired in Zambia. You will know that there are Zimbabweans who went there, a group of Zimbabweans that went to that particular country, Zimbabwe's northern neighbor, to protest against the incoming SADC chair. You know that Zimbabwe is supposed to take over as the next SADC chair for the next 2 years. That is in August, that 17th of August, when Zimbabwe hosts the next SADC summit. It is expected that Zimbabwe is going to take over the rotational chair position of the sub-regional organization. And that automatically means that President Emmerson Mnangagwa of Zimbabwe is going to be the chair of the sub-regional body for the next 2 years. But of course, there are a number of Zimbabweans who went to Zambia to organize a protest or to hold a protest against this happening, because they have a number of issues that they are raising, the main one being that Zimbabwe is not politically in a situation whereby it can be allowed to host or to hold the position of SADC chair because of a number of logjams politically that are existing in the country. You will know that there are complaints that the elections that happened on the 23rd and 24th of August last year were rigged. And there are also reports that there is continuing repression in Zimbabwe targeting opposition officials and perceived members and supporters of the opposition, CCC, and other pro-democracy activists and movements. So they went to Zambia to demonstrate, but as I've said, we had not yet been able to get the full picture of what exactly transpired in Zambia, in Lusaka, because of the conflicting reports that we are getting from different media houses. But as I had promised, that we are going to reach out to people who attended this event, or those that went with the intention of protesting. And lucky enough, we do have a member of the delegation that went there, and we spoke to him about what exactly transpired. So Trust Ndlovu, for those who do not know him, is or was the Citizens Coalition for Change chairperson for South Africa, but he speaks to us from Lusaka as the SADC Citizens Democratic Society director.
Good morning, Nube, and your listeners. Yes, we came to Zambia, and our intention was to stage a demo and a protest and hand over a petition to SADC leadership. Those who, as you know, that there was this SADC ministerial committee on organ trigger. So we know that they were going to talk, of course, and discuss, and as a preliminary issue before the SADC summit in Harare. So you know, these are foreign ministers, these are defense ministers, and the other securities on peace, security, and defense. So that's very critical. We realize that it's a platform that we could also express our displeasure regarding the issue of the outcome of elections in August 23, 2023 in Zimbabwe. And when we came here, we went to the police and did the notification process. But unfortunately, the notification process required, there's a rule in Zambia that requires 7 days notice, and we were out of time bound. But they, after notification, we waited for the police to respond to us. And as you know, that we only got the proper dates of this SADC event 3 days before the event, so it was just going to be impossible. So in the wisdom of the police in Zambia, they decided not to to allow the demo in the last minute, and we had to engage with them and peacefully, and we had to respect the laws of this country. So what happened is that we ended up going to the foreign ministry, where we handed the petition through the permanent secretary to the SADC Troika current chairperson, Mr. H.H. Lema. So we were assured, and everything was delivered, and it became a big story. And we are assured that the SADC Troika chairperson, the current one, is going to note our petition. So yes, we had of course media praises, and we try to demonstrate, as you know, as individuals away from the venue to different places, to highlight like our issues on placards and banners, you know. So it was a successful because we had we from the media press around here, and also from what we had. And we had a brief encounter yesterday with the police at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. When we followed up our petition issue, there was a letter that was required for us to attach in that file when we handed. So when we came out, we made a video when I was outside. That's when one of my colleague who was taking me the video was had his phone confiscated and interrogated. That's a brief detention, but he was then later released after they realized that we were not we did not mean any bad thing to Zambian government, and we had acted within our democratic way. So the other challenge in this country is that we have two factions in all government departments: the one that is pro the ruling, and the one that is of the view of Lungu, Edgar Lungu, the former president. So they support the former president, and they are hostile. But the former president, you know, the party. The opposition here, they're doing all tricks to sabotage and undermine the government of HH. So that creates problems, and they are using state institutions because they are in the state institutions to try to sabotage and undermine the current government. So with equal measure, I think the current government also is resorted to use the same tricks, then deny them that space to sabotage them, because it's an issue of using the state institutions, which is very bad. It's unlike in Zimbabwe, where the opposition has no access to state institutions because they've never been in government, and they are not in government, you know. So yes, these are the challenges that we have faced, but we managed to overcome. We really think it has an impact. What we did had an impact to SADC. Thank you.
Well, that's the voice of Mr. Trust Ndlovu, SADC Citizens Democratic Society Director. So that is what transpired in Zambia, where Zimbabweans had gone to protest against President Emmerson Mnangagwa and Zimbabwe taking over as the next chair of SADC in that rolling position. We will continue to reach out to several other organizations that either participated or are organizing protest against President Emmerson Mnangagwa and Zimbabwe taking over as the next SADC chair, because they believe that the time is not ripe for Zimbabwe to assume that particular key position because it comes with a number of responsibilities, one of which must be to show democracy and good governance, as well as allow personal freedoms, including the freedom of association, freedom of political choice, freedom of assembly, and to voice people's concerns. Thank you very much. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share it.